Today's episode of the success story has the Egyptian architect Ramses Wissa Wassef as its hero. Ramses Wissa Wassef was born in the year 1911. Ramses obtained the baccalaureate in the year 1928 from a French school, then traveled to France to study engineering, and there he obtained a diploma in architecture from the School of Fine Arts in Paris in 1935. Then he obtained a diploma in sculpture from Julian Academy in the same year. Then he returned to Cairo in general, where he was appointed as a teacher at the College of Fine Arts, which department of architecture he headed since the year 1965. Then he resigned to devote himself to his own cultural project. Ramses Wissa Wassef traveled on summer trips to Europe in 1937 until the year 1958 to visit art museums and learn about the latest theories of architecture in Italy, Belgium, France, Spain, North Africa, and Switzerland. Ramses Wissa Wassef founded the House of Art in Haranea in the year 1955, and he held exhibitions for wall carpets produced by his house in Cairo, in Alexandria, and in the various European countries. Haranea was a small village in Giza that was admired, and which tranquility was appreciated, and its nature was loved by him. And in the year 1952, he bought land and established his center for arts. Ramses Wissa Wassef relied and capitalized on the development of the creative sense of children side by side with the development of the professional sense, because he made them start with small looms, with a few strings, with few colors and types of strings that are easy to deal with, and over time the creative sense grows and scale of work grows with it to reach the large looms that work with more individual and variety of strings and colors that allow creative works of greater complexity to emerge. Ramses this awasive gave in 1972 an opportunity for seven newlyweds of artisanal artists working in the center that who do not own private homes to own the land adjacent to the center, to design their own homes and build them with their own hands. How to distribute these dwellings and link the group of seven dwellings to the village of Haranea by a corridor surrounded by a wall that was specially designed to ensure communication between them and the village and the natural community. And these dwellings open up to an open yard complex in the middle of the dwellings, while at the same time providing family privacy for each of them, thus achieving a strong bond between humans and between his environment and his work. Influenced by the Coptic architecture in many of the other buildings he designed, such as schools, homes, and villas, he also incorporated gypsum windows and stained glass into the finishes. He taught Coptic architecture and Coptic art at the Institute of Coptic Studies, Abbasia. He worked with the architect Hassan Fathi on building the village of Khurna in Luxor. His most famous work is an amendment of the Mahmoud Mukhtar Sculpture Museum. Cairo, the Coptic Museum in Zamalek, Cairo several churches, and Alexandria also, and in Damanhur, including the Church of St. George. His house in Aguza in Cairo, and several private homes along the road near the pyramids of Saqqara. The house of Adam Hanin, Haranea, Giza. Adam was his student at the Faculty of Fine Arts. Ramses Wissa Wasif Complex and Center of the Arts, Haranea, Giza, including workshops and an exhibition of textiles and sculpture, Habib Georgi Museum. Ramses Wissa Wasif designed the buildings of the center in the Coptic style that supports natural ventilation, and he took advantage also of daylight. Everything is done by old methods. Weaving is done by hand on wooden looms. Even the threads used in the fabric are dyed in the center with natural dyes extracted from plants that are planted in the land of the center. After the artist Ramses Wissawasse brought its seeds, the seeds of May colors from France and Switzerland, and the seeds were of grenade, pomegranate plants that give the orange and yellow colors, and it's called Risdon. And he attended also the blue indigo color that came from the Nile, which is called the Nila color or the indigo color, and it produces the dark blue color, which is the same dyes used in the ancient Coptic textiles. Ramses Wissawasse was also interested in the wonderful handcrafted Coptic weaving, which had an ancient world fame and considered a pioneer in its revival, as well through his center in the village of Haranea. At first, he tried to teach it to the makers of carpets and handmade kilims, but they could not change the preserved shapes they used to repeat throughout their life without creativity. It's better to start with children who teach them from the beginning the basics without spoiling the workmanship. The center included other handicrafts such as ceramics, pottery, and batik. And batik is the art of coloring fabrics with hot wax and dyes. Its products have reached all over the world. And the beautiful and joyful thing is that the work of these children has toured international art exhibitions and won many prizes, such as the 1957 Swiss Exhibition Prize. And only 2 years after the establishment of the center, the first builders of the Haranea Center were Nubians because of their experience in building beautiful Nubian houses with domes and vaults. Then Ramses Wissawasse taught the children how to prepare mud bricks and build walls, and they were able to build their homes. Pottery pens were the first things these children built, and they exist until now. Then the same group built workshops and galleries. Ramses Wissawasse's philosophy necessitated the integration between nature and man. In common with his companion in thought, engineer Hassan Fathi, and this was reflected in the buildings of the center that were made by the people of Haranea from the dried clay molds available in abundance there. Thank you. Ramses Wissawasif relied on teachers for the craft. The building is from the far reaches of Upper Egypt and provided by the Sheikh or the head of the architects, Hassan Fathi, in order to teach the people of Haranea how to build their homes and workshops. Also relied upon the expansion of the center on his experience in the arts of the Middle Ages in Egypt, which carries a unique mixture that combines Pharaonic, Coptic, and Islamic architecture, and making the people of Haranea build domes and cellars from mud blocks, the dyer using ancient methods away from modern methods that do not respect the environment from his point of view, and employ the machine at the expense of the human being. Ramses Wissawasif received special medals from Italy for the drawings and designing of the Church of St. George in Heliopolis in the year 1954. He also won a prize at the 1957 Switzerland exhibition. Ramses Wissawasif was also awarded the State Encouragement Prize for Window Art in the year 1960, as well as the State Encouragement Prize for Arts in 1961, and after his departure, his name was honored through the Aga Khan Cultural Awards in the year 1983, and his position is seen as one of the world's leading sustainable development experiences.
Thank you.
Mr. Wassef believed that the human capacity for innate creativity was not exploited properly until his death. This belief was a strong motivation in the formation of his architectural identity, which depends on the development of the sense of innate creativity in every person, regardless of the degree of education and qualifications. After the death of Ramses Wissa Wassef in 1974, his wife Sophie Wissa and his children undertook the work and supervised the center, completing the artist's dream that every person in Hananea would become an artist by nature, producing unique works impossible to repeat twice, as he succeeded in succeeding Wissa Wassef in adding many other handicrafts, such as handicraft ceramics, wraps, and handmade clothing. It's worth noting that the work of the children of Hananea has traveled all over the world, and he remained the father of architecture and the Coptic fabric after his death, and was able to immortalize his name in the record of the great engineers as well as weavers.